for his praise will continually be in our mouth.
Yes.
Thank you for joining. Thank you for joining in our parking lot service on radio station 89.9 on the FM dial, or our live stream and virtual praise, Zoom, and worship service of the Friendship Baptist Church of Hopewell, Virginia.
Yes.
Where we love God, love others, and serve our community. Today we are celebrating Father's Day. The men, the brothers. To our fathers, thank you for mentoring all youth and not just those in your household, for you have made our community safer and better by taking the time to mold and develop children and our youth to be positive impacts in our neighborhood. Despite the disparaging reports that blame many of the issues facing the black communities in America as a direct result of stereotypes of black fathers, we at Friendship Baptist Church are recognizing those black fathers and other fathers who are involved in their children's lives and participate in the mentoring capacity of youth in the community. Providing critical care, reading to them, helping them with their homework and chores, and introducing them to a faith relationship with God. We celebrate you to praise God for you and for giving us a visible image and the likeness of the Father that God has prepared you to be. Today, let's keep ourselves safe and healthy through the practicing of safe measures in public to prevent the spread of disease, infection, and isolation among our communities.
Yes.
Our call to worship declares, listen carefully to God's wisdom. Take heart what he can teach you. You will treasure its sweetness deep within. Join us as we posture ourselves for prayer as Reverend Benjamin Jackson Jr. opens our service with our invocational prayer.
Grace and mercy, once again, just saying thank you. Thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you've continued to do. Father, we thank you for the fathers. We thank you for the father figures. Now, Father, we ask you right now, being our light, our guide, our inspiration, being our everything, we ask you to fill us right now with your peace, your love, your generosity, your hope, your desires, most importantly, your love, that your will be done on this earth. Allow your spirit to transform our hearts and our minds during this service. Speak to us, Lord. Speak to us that we no longer do our will, but conform to yours. Bless us right now. Remove everything that hinders us from following your Son, Jesus. Line us up with your word. Give us your peace. This is my prayer and petition. In Jesus' name, fall fresh on us, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Opening praise on this special day. We do not own the rights to this music used in this worship experience, but it's ministered for our joy and blessing. Our God, our Father in heaven, we worship and we praise you. We thank you, Lord, for being the God that you are. You provide us with life itself, and you bless us to see the dawning of each new day. And for these things, we thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, that we can worship in person and on social media. We thank you, Lord, for social media. That it provided a way for us to hear your sermons and hear your message while we were locked in from the pandemic. We thank you, Lord, and we ask, Lord, that you show us other opportunities where we may be able to hear your word and get your word out to the people that need to hear it. We thank you, Lord, for those vaccines that were produced so that we can safely return to our church homes and visit our family and friends. We thank you, Lord, for all these blessings. We pray, dear Father, that you would bless the sick with your healing powers and comfort those who lost loved ones. We ask that you bless the members and friends who are witnessing this sermon this morning. We pray, Lord, that we will hear a word from you that will bless our souls and encourage us to hear more and think more about you and your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray for the mission, that you will bless the mission of this church while we love you, love others, and serve our community. We pray for the ministries of this church, that you will bless them in their ministry to others and to do the work that you set for them. We pray, Lord, that you will bless the pastor and our first lady as they preach, teach, and minister to others. We pray, Lord, that you will keep them safe and keep them steadfast as they accomplish that awesome task that you've given them. And Father, let us not forget the men on this Father's Day and Men Mentorship Day. We thank you, Father, for those men who provided for us when we couldn't provide for ourselves.
Thank you.
Yes. We thank you, Lord, for those men who continue to provide for us with mentorship during our lifetime. We just thank you, Lord, for all of those things that you provide for us. And Lord, as our men's ministry continues to grow, we pray, Lord, that you will bless us and order our steps that we may be a healthy men or healthy church. That we find opportunities where we can mentor to others. And Lord, help us to be, that we persevere in doing the work that you call us to do.
In the name of Jesus.
And Lord, our great Father in heaven.
Hallelujah.
You are awesome. What will we do about you?
Jesus.
You are like no other Father.
Jesus.
You gave your only Son.
Glory.
Only Son to us.
Thank you.
Who may show us the way for a short time. We thank you, Lord, for that.
Thank you.
And what did he do? He laid down his life for us.
Hallelujah.
In the book of John, it says, no greater love.
No greater.
Than one who would lay down his life for us. And Father, he died for all of us.
Thank you,
Lord, for that fatherhood and for that love.
Yes, God.
But Jesus was also a great mentor. He mentored his disciples to where he taught them how to pray, how to minister to others, and how to spread his word.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Lord, for those examples.
Thank
and we
you, Lord.
Pray, Lord, that we can be more Christ-like in our faith walk. Father, we thank you for all of your blessings. And we pray that you will never withhold your love, grace, and mercy from us. These are our prayers and petitions with thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
truly today.
Yes, God.
Not just Christian fathers,
Jesus,
but
Jesus.
Every last one of us.
Yeah.
Use us, Lord.
Just use us.
Yes, God. Yeah. Glory. Thank you, Lord.
In the midst of those who still feel we're in a pandemic, use
Jesus.
Us.
Yes,
in the midst of those who still feel that there is social injustice and racial profiling and criminality that has become so psychotic.
Jesus.
Use us, Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
In this day and age where fatherhood must go beyond the confines of a father's household.
Jesus.
And reach out into their community and mentor. Use us, Lord, in your service. Speak now and let your Holy Ghost fall upon those in the sanctuary, those in their vehicles, those on social media outlets like Zoom and live stream. Speak, Lord. For we want to celebrate the fathers you intended for this world to have. Speak now. And when you speak, fill us. Cleanse us. Inspire us. Motivate us to be more and more and more like Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said, amen. As we celebrate Father's Day this morning, we certainly want to encourage those who have made this celebration, taking the leadership in this. And so we want to praise God for our men's ministry, our special events committee, and under the leadership in our men's ministry of Diaconate William Thomas, Reverend Benjamin Jackson Jr., and Trustee Kirk Jones. We thank them for making this possible. We've had a weekend of celebration. We've had a good time. And now we just need to hear from the Lord.
Amen.
We want to encourage you this morning with a very usual and familiar passage, but we want to encourage you in an unusual practice that needs to become usual.
Amen.
From the 22nd chapter of Proverbs and verse 6, most of us have heard it in the vernacular of train a child in the way they should go. But for today's purpose and reflection, might we look at it from the Message translation, which has particular words of emphasis, wherein it reads in this fashion, point your kids in the right direction. Point your kids in the right direction. When they are old, they won't be lost. You may have your seats in the house of God. We want to encourage you just for a few moments this morning as we celebrate Father's Day and fatherhood. Mentor them in the right direction. Mentor them. I know that's a word that many of us don't associate with as well as we once did. But let me just say, we've been mentoring all of our lives. If you have amounted to anything at all, it is because somebody, somewhere, mentored you. Some of us like to say it this way, my grandma and my grandpa, well, whatever they did, it was called mentoring. Some will say my mama and my daddy did it, my uncle, my stepfather, my
father figure, my mother figure, whoever it was that made you successful in where you are, you can attribute the fact that somebody somewhere mentored you.
Amen.
And so we celebrate Father's Day today, and we celebrate those who wear that needed responsibility in our households and communities called Father. Yes, when you say father, daddy, da-da, pops, it ought to mean something.
Amen.
We celebrate those fathers who go by those names of affection, who are there for their children and other youth during their pandemics of demoralizing influences. A troubled society that has trenched them with racism, social injustices, psychopathic criminality, and even neglect.
Amen.
We thank you, fathers of this 21st century, who have risen above the weakened disciplines that have come from our homes and our schools and our churches to be positive role models of mentorship to their kids and to the kids of others who have chosen to be denied their parental privileges and practice the great privilege and right of fatherhood. You see, my dear hearers, in 2021, black children are disproportionately more likely to have lost a parent due to COVID-19. Public school districts like Hopewell and others are witnessing children of color suffering inordinately from remote learning. The need for criminal justice reform to give young black men opportunities for employment, housing, the right to vote, and yes, social services, including financial aid to improve their re-entry conditions into society. We tip our hats to you, men who have taken the role of fatherhood, who involve themselves in the various mentorship programs of their churches, their communities, their schools, who have been a vital part of strengthening connections within our communities by providing youth with a father figure, male role model, to enhance our children and the children of our communities with academic performance, mental health, social and emotional well-being, and preventing risky behaviors. Thank you, Pops. Thank you, Dada. Thank you, Daddy-O. Thank you, Papa. Thank you for being consistent in mentoring them in the right direction.
Amen.
Thank you. Whether you use big brothers, big sisters, whether you use the school mentoring programs, whether you participate through mega mentors, men's ministries and churches, men on a mission, and other men mentoring outlets throughout our communities, we want to thank you for standing tall and making a difference. I am always quick, no matter where I am, when somebody makes the comment that this world is going to hell quickly, I make a comment, no, it's not. Because as long as there's one person guiding somebody in the right direction, you're just focusing on one area in your community. But I know in every community there's somebody somewhere that is trying to point their kids in the right direction.
Amen.
Yes, today, under the guidance and direction of God's Spirit, we want to encourage you that your sacrifices of mentoring in your homes, around your jobs, within your communities and schools, and in neglected areas of our neighborhoods, you are giving hope to our youth. You're giving our youth a destiny of purpose.
You are giving our youth the stability to keep our communities and nations vigilant in restoring love, humanitarian service, and goodwill. This familiar text from Proverbs 22 and 6 describes there is a right direction that God has for youth to go in. See, my dear hearers, if you really want to change what you don't like in your community, follow God's direction.
Amen.
I don't know why we make this a difficult journey and a difficult aspect of our situations, but all we got to do is trust God's guidance.
Amen.
See, God promises that if we use his direction, that young people still may do some foolish things.
Yes.
But somewhere, because they had a constant mentoring in the right direction, they will grow up and mature and start making better decisions. Yes, yes. Everywhere where we see children, instead of getting better, they're getting worse. The only thing lacking in their lives is positive mentoring in the right direction. Let me just say this now for some who will write us off and say how difficult it is to get it to be a part of an organization that practices mentoring to our youth. Let me just say anything worthwhile ought to be a little bit of a struggle. Anything that's easy to accomplish, that ought to be your sign that it's not for us. Because anything worthwhile, it takes sacrifice, it takes struggle, it takes hardship. It's going to be difficult to do. So I thank God today that under the guidance and direction of God's Spirit, we're going to see today that whether we're in our homes, in our jobs, around our communities, we're going to see an opportunity. We're going to be encouraged by the direction of God that we can mentor our youth in the right direction. Particularly as God directs us how to have children to go in their life of growing up and maturing, going from boys to men and from girls to ladies. Notice I didn't say a woman. You see, a woman will still do some things that girls do, but a lady just can't do that. Now, somebody's gonna get that in a minute. You see, there's some grown men who do some boyish stuff. But as soon as they learn the right way, the right direction, grown men will do grown men stuff. Yes, yes. And so each of us today, especially those who wear the divine blessing of fatherhood, must mentor in the text is called guiding them in the right direction. But we must mentor our youth to choose the right direction that God has prepared for each of them. And so Proverbs 22:6 shares to all who are willing to listen and heed this commandment, this directive, this urging to make our communities better by mentoring youth in the right direction. He allows us by warning us, listen and take heed that without mentoring in the right direction, youth will easily walk in the wrong path. Many of us know this as we experience raising our own children, that if we have done the right direction, that when our children start to do something wrong or walk in the wrong direction, all we have to do is call their name. In the black community, if you get your whole name called, you better pay attention. Know that if you get a clap followed by your name in a loud voice, you better stop.
Amen.
And pay attention.
I know that.
And for some of us, it's going way back. I know now there may be some legislation against it, but some of us, if we heard grandma rattle that bush and start the sound of leaves coming off that little twitch, we know grandma got something to say.
Hallelujah.
Wish I was talking to somebody up here.
Hallelujah.
See, if we don't point our kids in the right direction, when they're old, the meaning of getting old means the age where they should have learned how to walk in the right direction. But because they're older now, they've done it so long, doing what's wrong seems right. The text says they're going to be lost. Lost in the text means that they will turn off from doing what's right and rebel against the very things that are important to them. Lord, I believe Tyler Perry, the show didn't have the best actors, but the title had it right. If loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right. Yes, I believe some of us have gotten to that point because we have no mentoring, we've had no guidance, we've had no direction in the spiritual affairs, that we do grown folks stuff in very childish ways, and we don't have any intent of changing it up. One of the things that I've come to learn and mature as a grown man is that when somebody gives you correction, the proper response is not to belittle the person who's offering the correction. Even if you feel the correction is not for you, the appropriate response is yes, ma'am, yes, sir. But you see, we live in a day today where we have grown folk calling their relatives and their parents by their first name. Lord have mercy, I wish I would call Kate by her first name. She would slap me until grandma came out. We don't use the terms of Mr. and Miss no more. We don't use the vernacular, yes ma'am, no ma'am. And we wonder why some of our children are neglected and overlooked because they come in a house and into a school and onto public ground and act like they're the big kahunas around here. But the reality is, if you want to be big, you better learn to be respectful. Wish I had somebody else in here this morning that would help me preach this. You see, the text describes that people will rebel. People will turn off to being in a church because they see too many negligent Christians instead of helpful ones. Lord have mercy. If you're in the house of the Lord and you know that you've been bought with a price and you know that God has snatched you as a branch that was burning, that you were once lost in your sin, but God put you on a road called straight, you ought to tell somebody that the Lord has been good to you. You ought not be so high. You ought not be so mighty that you can't help somebody. If I could help somebody as I pass along my living, would not be in vain. Yes, we've got to be able to mentor and influence and embrace them from going in the wrong direction. You see, when we refuse to help our young people to learn to respect others, to learn to have a purpose and a goal, to learn to not cheat than to repeat, you will find out that you might just diminish a little hatred in their hearts. You may not have so much insurrection and prejudice and isolation going on in our communities. Well, without mentoring, poor parenthood, especially from fatherhood, is described in the text as lost, meaning a father's lack of influence on his children or youth in one's community will cause an emotional attack on everything. And so they decide whether or not they're going to have a vaccination or not, whether or not they're going to turn on the TV and do Xbox instead of their remote learning and school. Poor fatherhood practices will cause father's successes to be their child's success. I don't care how good you are, Daddy. every child is not going to mimic what you do. I don't care how wonderful you are. Every child is not going to embrace the hobbies you embrace. And then some of the poor parenthood will show poor signs of mentorship and cause children and youth in our communities to be emotionally out of control. You can keep on being prideful, Daddy, and never let your children see a tear fall down your cheek. That they never see you upset. That they never see you when others treat you bad. That you show them how you ought to treat yourself better. Because if they never see it in you, they will lose control at school. They'll talk back to the teacher. They will even raise up with the ruler and strike out at another adult. Well, I want you to know that if we keep on being poor parents, what will happen is we will lose empathy. We won't have the ability to feel the pain and hurt of another person. We will find ourselves extremely controlling, that we don't worry about what our children say. We'll just say, just do what I told you to do. Your child will tell you what is going on with them, but you won't be able to help them because you got your own interpretation about what's going on with your child. Can I give you a sidebar this morning? If you don't join PTA, if you don't show up to school and show up on remote learning with your child, you don't have the right to tell your child what's not right in school. You need to see it for yourself, because contrary to popular opinion, we have some great teachers and great administrators in our public schools, but they got a few trifling teachers and staff members too. You've got to be willing to get involved with them, because if we're not allowing them to go in the right direction, and that it comes from a father's love, they will strike out in strange and unusual ways. Sometimes we'll say, I don't know how that child got that way. My little grandson is only 2.5 years old, but when he's decided he's had enough, he has a certain look. And to make sure that somebody is observing his communication, he will bat his eyes at you real quick to make sure, are you looking at me, pop, pop? I'm trying to tell you, I'm done with that. I want to move on to something else. Well, I come by to tell you, I'm tired of poor fatherhood that has taken the last sign of it's just my baby's daddy. I'm tired of poor fatherhood that has taken the last daddy to jail for failure to support their child or their children. I'm tired of poor fatherhood that has taken the last statistic for the outrage of youth left without meaningful mentoring, because God has done a movement today. God has changed the atmosphere. God has allowed his spirit to move upon the face of the earth, and he has raised up in our communities a few fathers who have raised their children with love, given them quality time. Thank you, Akeem. We have seen the Spirit of God fall on some men who have scheduled time to mentor other youth, to develop strategies of successful saving and banking. Well, God's Spirit has continued to move. So that on the earth, there's a few fathers who have built schools for children of color to know their true history of what they have endured, what they have overcome, and what they can be in this world. Thank you, Brother Wilson, down there in Atlanta, Georgia. God's Spirit has moved on fathers who are uncles and fathers in waiting, who rally people all across this country to donate learning supplies to needy children, to have all the resources they need to get the best learning available. Thank you, Mr. Mike. God's Spirit has raised fathers who have raised their children but thought it not robbery to go into the communities, go into their neighborhoods, go into the homes of others to raise others' youth in love, to get them to serve others, and to get them to be good citizens. Thank you, Men's Ministry of Friendship Baptist Church. But let me tell you, all the good fathers out there and those who desire to be good fathers, there's some good news I want to leave you with from the text. Too many people look at train a child and watch them go, and when they get old, they won't depart from it. But let me tell you why they won't depart from it. Because a good father, those fathers that we honor this morning, those fathers who will be giving these loving tokens of love this morning, we want to encourage you that you didn't do it by yourself. You've been mentoring in the right direction, but it's not because you're tall and dark and handsome. It's not because you know a few things. It's not because you've influenced a few people. Proverbs 22:6 says that fathers who point kids in the right direction so that when they get old they won't be lost, have some divine help. You see, the other point of the word point in the right direction, the first meaning is mentor, but the second meaning is to be guided by another force. Any good daddy has another force. He has a guide that's above every guide. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. He's Emmanuel, and he walks with us. He talks with us. He tells us that we are his own. This guide helps fathers mentor youth to make good choices. This guide mentors fathers to help children not be lost. This guide called Jesus will mentor fathers to change diapers and feed their own babies. This guide called Jesus will mentor fathers to make whatever sacrifices are necessary for youth and children to succeed in the pandemic of life. Jesus, our elder guide, will mentor men to be fathers that mentor other youth. You have no fatherly advice until you get the advice from the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Jesus will guide us through this pilgrim land. When you are weak, fathers, this guide will strengthen you. This guide will prop you up on every leaning side. This guide will love us and give grace to us when we fall short in the fatherhood race. So we salute you today, fathers. We praise God for you today, fathers. Keep on mentoring. Keep on loving. Keep on, keep keep on guiding them in the right direction. And God will.
Yes, he will.
Keep you propped up.
Yes, he will.
On every leaning side.
Oh, yes, he will.
God bless you and God keep you. Yes, in Jesus' name.
Yes,
we want to encourage those today.
Hallelujah.
Who are with us.
Yes.
And those who have joined us by way of our social media. We've talked about a guide that will guide you to be the best father,
yes,
the best parent.
Yes.
But we want you to know he'll guide you,
yes, he will,
to be the best individual that you can be. And so today, if you haven't had that opportunity, right now we'll say a few words. And if you believe them, you're on your way.
Amen.
You see, you need to believe that your hope,
amen,
and the answer to the rest of your,
amen,
life,
amen,
resides in this guide called Jesus. If you're willing to sacrifice your way of living and to be guided by Jesus and his way of living, your life will be changed for the better, and you'll find yourself loving him, loving others, and serving your community. We invite you to embrace that Jesus. And if you have today, you now need to get in a good Bible-based church. Friendship Baptist Church opens its doors to you. You can use our social media information to contact us, or you can call us at 804-458-0276. Someone will talk to you. Be glad to guide you through this process. We want to create more positive role models in our community, and we believe Jesus can help you to do that today. For those who have been blessed by this service, we want to encourage you to bless us with your financial gifts through our Givenify online giving at Friendship Baptist Church Hopewell. And we would thank you in advance for blessing us that we may continue to be a positive impact in our community. We pray today that today's celebration of fatherhood and this worship experience has been a blessing to you. And we pray that you will join us again next week when we come with our broadcast of love one more time. Until then, will you bow your heads in a posture of prayer as we offer our benediction to you?
Yes.
Lord, may our faith grow deeper.
Yes.
May our love spread wider.
Yes.
May our efforts of mentoring others in the right direction bring peace to this world. For our God, Jesus, is our peace. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. We love you right back. Join us again next week, and we look forward to seeing you. We love you right back.